Thank you for staying with us here on the Education Roundtable. We're talking about the machine trades and welding programs at San Bernardino Valley College, your local community college. And in our third segment here, we have an alum and a current student and an employee, thanks to his education at Valley College, Jimmy DeMarco.
Thanks for having me here, Craig.
Good to have you, Jimmy. So first of all, tell us how you first came to the San Bernardino Valley College campus.
Well, I first came to San Bernardino Valley College in 2010 after I had gotten out of the military. Was looking for a way to make money in the future and could use my GI Bill for it. And I first got started looking at other things than welding. First started looking at actually law enforcement.
Okay.
Was looking to maybe become a police officer, and then I realized I probably wasn't exactly the best guy for it. So I thought about maybe going on to become a lawyer or something of that nature. Well, after being there for some time, I finally was like, you know, I really don't like doing a lot of paperwork, and that's just not me. So I ended up talking to some friends of mine, and they were like, hey, man, you like working with your hands. You like doing all this stuff. Why don't you try welding or something like that? So I ended up changing my major over to welding after I'd already gotten an AA in history.
Okay.
Go figure. Waste a couple of years. But, hey, actually found something I enjoyed doing.
Okay. Excellent. So describe your experience in the welding program at Valley College.
At first, it was different.
Okay.
I'd gotten a little bit of practice in a buddy of mine's garage with a little Lincoln buzz box. You know, mm-hmm. It just wasn't much of anything. So I got started with some oxy fuel welding, and then after that moved over to some stick, which is shielded metal arc welding.
Okay.
Then tried a little bit of TIG and some flux core and some MIG, a bunch of different processes that they have
right,
there.
Right.
And gradually it just started to come together for me.
Okay, so how long was the program from start to finish welding?
You can actually bust out the program if you really work hard at it within a year to a year and a half.
Okay.
I mean, it's a lot of stuff that you have to do during that time, though.
Right.
It's being there sometimes 10 hours a day.
Wow, that's intense.
It's like a job.
Yeah, okay. So you're finishing up the program and you're thinking, all right, now I've got these skills and I know how to do all these things. What am I going to do for a job? Take us through that process.
Actually, that was the interesting part. Right as I was starting to finish up my program, I noticed that there were some flyers being posted around campus for an internship at California Steel.
Okay.
When I actually looked at these flyers, I didn't even notice the pay at first. I noticed the benefits.
Uh-huh.
I was okay. Like, okay, medical, dental, vision, 401k, life insurance, all great perks. And then I noticed the pay. Mm-hmm. I was like, I'd be a fool not to try for this.
Right. So take us through the process. What did you have to do?
First, there was a orientation that you had to go through.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't much. It was sitting there listening to people like Rick and Ron and a few other people come in and actually tell you about California Steel and what would be required of the internship program. The second step was a written test. It was a four-section test, things like reading comprehension, math, mechanical aptitude, things of that nature. It was mm-hmm. really simple.
Mm-hmm.
You just had to pay attention to actually get it.
Okay.
After that step came a panel interview. During this panel interview, you were actually brought into the CSI property where they had a group of experienced mechanical maintenance personnel, the lead men, actually sit there and talk to you, ask you questions, ask you what do you know, how would you do it, things of that nature.
Okay.
And that could be a little hairy.
Sure, a little intimidating.
I mean, a little intimidating.
Yeah, sure.
But you know, as long as you are confident mm-hmm. and actually do know your stuff, then it shouldn't be too intimidating for you.
Okay. I'm following you through the story there. So you got accepted into the program. What did you hear? What was your feeling when you heard you got accepted?
When I first heard I got accepted, I was excited beyond belief. It was like, hey, here's an actual opportunity for once. I mean, it's when I It was really bad for the economy here. It's been for a while.
Right.
But this was like a godsend.
Awesome. So talk about the transition from student to intern to now employee.
Well, going from intern to employee was really different. I mean, when you were a student to intern, you still had 3 days of the week that you were going to school.
Okay.
And working 2 days a week.
Mm-hmm.
Going from intern to employee, you had to take another test. This one was more job-oriented.
Okay.
What have you learned? What have they taught you?
Mm-hmm.
And that one, I mean, it covers a lot of stuff that you wouldn't get out of, you know, just welding. You
okay.
have to learn about hydraulics, pneumatics, things of that nature.
Okay.
Then going to the full-time career, I can tell you one thing. I wake up every day, I'm actually excited to go to work.
That's great.
It's not a, oh man, I have to get up, I don't want to. It's like a, hey, I get to go to work today.
Right.
I get to, every day it's something new, it's something different. It's an exciting career.
So do you see yourself as having future opportunities there as a lifetime type career?
I do actually, yeah. It's something that I honestly want to make my career.
That's great.
I want to make my living off of CSI by working there, and it's hard work, but it's the kind of work that when you go home, you actually feel like you accomplished something.
Wow, that's great. Well, one last question before we go. What recommendations do you have for anyone who's thinking about welding or machine trades as a career?
My biggest recommendation would not only be attention to detail, learning, you gotta open your horizon.
Okay.
Don't just take welding courses or machining courses. Tie them together.
Okay.
Take a little bit of welding, a little bit of machining, a little bit of automotive, get all that together, and you can actually go really far in CSI.
That's great. Well, Jimmy, thank you for sharing your story with us. Congratulations on your career.
Thank you.
Thank you for your service.
Not a problem.
And thank you for watching the Education Roundtable.